Welcome to the presentation of my do-it-yourself retro-style arcade cabinet. My name is Matthias. I'm an academic painter, illustrator, art teacher, and collector of video games from the 80s and 90s.
The cabinet that you're looking at was obviously inspired by a Donkey Kong machine from 1981. Since the Donkey Kong cabinet is one of the most iconic cabinets ever made, this was the first choice for my design. I made some changes to the measurements and built it less deep since I installed a 17-inch 4x3 LCD monitor instead of a CRT screen. It's also a little shorter and slimmer than an original Donkey Kong cabinet. According to some information that I found on the internet, the first run of the Donkey Kong cabinets was built out of plywood, so that was the material I wanted to use for this and my future cabinet builds. The artwork was entirely created by me. I didn't copy a single element from the internet and everything has been drawn from scratch. I wanted the most famous antagonists in video game history, Nintendo's Mario and Sega's Sonic, to be represented in the artwork. The plexiglass for the marquee, bezel and control panel have the artwork printed on the back side. The marquee is lit by a simple USB-powered LED strip. Inside the machine works a hacked NES Classic Mini with some added extra games. Input lag can be a problem with these mini consoles, but I found that when connected to this LCD monitor with a cheap HDMI to VGA adapter, there is almost zero lag. I usually test this with Crazy Bikers or Motocross Maniacs if you live in the US for the Game Boy Color. This game requires exact time. The NES Classic Mini was obviously designed to be displayed on a modern 16x9 screen, and since I'm using a 4x3 screen and the NES Mini has no spread-to-fit display option, I had to fiddle around with the emulator settings to make everything look perfect. Only the game selection screen looks squeezed, but this is something that you get used to in no time. All games are displayed in the correct 4x3 aspect ratio during gameplay. This NES Classic Mini was hacked following the instructions of a tutorial from the Patent Place channel. There are a total of 80 games on the NES Mini. NES, Super NES, Master System, Mega Drive, Genesis, Game Boy, Game Boy Color, PC Engine and TurboGrafx-16. I wanted the total amount of installed games to be somewhat manageable and can't understand why some people load thousands of games on their emulator machine. A friend of mine asked me, why don't you just use a Raspberry Pi for your project? You won't have to deal with limited storage space and can have thousands of games in your cabinet. First, I don't need thousands of games and I don't want thousands of games. But the main reason why I refuse to use a Raspberry Pi mini computer is the importance for me to have, in this case, an authentic, official Nintendo product inside the machine. This may not be a problem for most people, but it's really important to me. The joysticks have been wired to the PCB of two very cheap no-name SNES Classic Mini joypads. This is really easy to do, no special skills required here. The entire soldering and wiring of all the buttons and joysticks took me approximately 2 hours. I tried to keep the number of buttons on the control panel as low as possible for aesthetical reasons, since the average 80s arcade cabinets never had more than 4 buttons per player, as far as I can remember. Of course, such SNES hits as Super Mario Kart, Killer Instinct, Street Fighter 2 Turbo and the Mortal Kombat series won't be playable with these few buttons, but that was a trade-off I was willing to make. The joysticks I used for this cabinet are very cheap ones, with a square restrictor gate. I replaced them later on with two Sanwa joysticks equipped with octagonal restrictor gates. Hidden underneath the control panel is a small amplifier to adjust the sound volume to full blast or total silence. Except for the screen and mini amplifier, everything is powered by a 4-port USB power brick. On the back door of the cabinet there is an identification plate made out of aluminum. There was a lot of trial and error involved in making this, until I was happy with the result. This was achieved without the use of a router or laser engraving machine. The plate says one of a kind, as I won't build two identical cabinets. Every cabinet will be different one from another. The making of this small plate was the toughest part of the entire cabinet build. Absolutely not an easy task. Behind the front door, which can be locked with the same key as the back door, is a drawer equipped with full extension slides. The drawer on the bottom has no slides installed and drops on the floor when pulled out. This is a safety feature to prevent the cabinet from tipping over when my 21 months old daughter decides to climb into the drawer. I built this cabinet for my two daughters whose combined age is less than 2 years. The idea was to raise my little girls with the right culture when it comes to video games of historical value. When they reach their adult age and look back to the time when they were children, I wish them to have fond childhood memories and this cabinet being part of their memories as a piece of furniture that has always been around as long as they can think. An object where they were able to store their toys in and could have fun with playing ancient video games with her dad. I built these cabinets for you, Hannah and Eva.
If you like the shirt I'm wearing, you can find these and other designs in my Spreadshirt shop by clicking on the link below. If you're interested in my next projects, please like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. See you next time.